Hey guys, the knocking sound you just heard, this is piston slap. This was on a coal engine that I had just started. Timestamps are here if you want to skip to the conclusion. I'll start off with what piston slap is, then secondly, what an Italian tune-up is, which I didn't expect to include in this video. Thirdly, why I chose this oil, and then the conclusion. I'll try to keep this short and simple. In an engine, you have your engine block that has cylinders. For example, a four-cylinder engine, four cylinders. You have pistons that move inside these cylinders. The pistons have piston rings, which scrape against the cylinder wall. This does wear over time, and if you are burning oil, oil is getting past these piston rings. The piston itself isn't a perfect shape. It is wider at the bottom. This is the piston skirt, which helps stabilize the piston in the cylinder and promote a good ring seal by preventing the piston from rocking too much as it moves up and down. The piston skirt can wear over time. When this happens, as the piston is moving up and down, it will rock and hit the cylinder wall, thus causing the knocking sound you heard at the start of the video. Now, unless you open the engine up, you cannot be 100% sure. But this is an educated guess, and the biggest clue is that the knocking stops when the engine warms up. Basically, when the piston warms up, it will expand and the now excessive gap will be filled, thus no more knocking. If the knocking does not go away, it could be a rod knock, and you should get that checked ASAP. Things could end very badly. Another possibility is the piston could be hitting the valves as it reaches the top of its cycle. On Honda engines, the valves need to be adjusted manually. I did my valve adjustment 30,000 kilometers ago, so I know it's fine. This is an Italian tune-up. Basically, you want to drive your engine hard. It's easier to do this on a highway because you have more room and a higher speed limit. Do this only when your engine is properly warmed up. Here, I'm at the speed limit of 100 and I am in third gear. If you have an auto, lock in your gear or gear ratio or keep it in S mode. However, do not keep it continuously at a fixed high RPM as this can heat up your transmission. So vary your load. I'm not really worried with my manual transmission, but with autos, you need to be a bit more careful, especially with CVTs. The idea behind this Italian tune-up is that you are working the engine harder, which will result in higher engine temps. This can help remove some carbon buildup in various parts of your engine. This, however, may vary due to differences in engine design. I am on a 10 kilometer stretch, and this is my daily route, and this is more than enough for me. Because I have a manual transmission, I do flog it every now and then. Why did I choose this oil? All oils have their own formulation, their own additives to help with engine friction. This oil by Liqui Moly Molygen has a higher concentration of friction modifiers. This Molygen third generation oil says it uses organic friction modifiers with molybdenum. Organic friction modifiers reduce friction and wear by absorbing onto metal surfaces. While doing research on piston slap, I saw someone say to use an oil with molybdenum extra friction additives. This is why I gave it a shot. I am not endorsing Liqui Moly, but I'm not in the US, for example, where I have a lot of options. This was the only easily available oil I could get that had extra friction control. Now the conclusion where I tie everything together. I started noticing this knocking piston slap sound around August 2023. It would happen once every week or two. Till the end of April 2024, it got worse frequency-wise, that it would happen every other day. After 2-3 minutes of driving, it would disappear. I believe this is at an early stage because this only happens if I accelerate when the RPM is on the lower side, when the engine is cold. I cannot hear it at a higher RPM. At cold starts, the RPM is around 1500 until it warms and settles down to around 900. Driving a manual car, sometimes you let the RPM drop at or below 1000 at lower speeds. This is when the knocking would happen. To date, only 4 times it knocked while accelerating at higher RPMs above 1500 on a coal engine. The only permanent solution is to replace the affected piston, but tearing down the engine just for this isn't feasible in my opinion. The Liqui Moly oil really helped. Now let me give this a rating where the original knocking sound is at 10. After using this oil, the sound reduced to 6. Very noticeable difference. I wasn't expecting this. I noticed this change after about 800 kilometers on the oil. More importantly, the frequency has reduced. It rarely happens now. And that is due to two reasons. Firstly, this oil helped. There's no doubt about it. Then secondly, I am careful with the RPM. I do not let the RPM drop too much on a cold engine in the first couple of minutes. I've not been able to capture the knocking sound after as it's not frequent. Okay, now where does an Italian tune-up come into play? Well, roughly for the last year and a half, I was losing a bit of oil due to leaks, so I was easy on the engine. I fixed the leaks and I did 2 spirited runs around 2 months ago. The sound of the knock when it would occasionally happen further reduced. I would say the rating now it's at 4. This one has me confused. Maybe there was some carbon buildup on top of the piston, maybe other parts of the engine. Now after, maybe the engine runs a touch smoother, thus the rocking of the piston is less. Lots of maybes, I really don't know, but I ain't complaining. Would love to hear your thoughts on this. As for the oil, I will continue to use this oil. If you have piston slab, give such oils a try and see if it helps. But follow your manufacturer's recommended oil if it requires certain specifications. I would appreciate a subscribe if you liked my content. As always, thanks for watching.